midline approach is going to be particularly, we don't use anymore, as I was mentioning, for more anterior approach, particularly for foramen, posterior foramen magnum, for fourth ventricle, and for example, chiari malformation. All these approaches can be, can only lesion can be approached with the with midline suboccipital. Now there is different sitting position, which is a very, in theory, is a good position. A lot of surgeons use it. I don't particularly favor it, just my own, I don't use it because I don't like being tired with my hands, particularly if they work for a long time, pineal, particularly for pineal lesion. And another thing, because venous embolism, air embolism, and that's a very bad complication as well. Prone position, I usually don't use, I use mostly the modified park bench, lateral decubitus, or very popular is the prone position as well. Skin incision in midline goes all the way from the torque all the way down to the C2, C3, and according to what you after to, you know, if you have lesion on the fourth ventricle or for decompression, posterior decompression for a chiari malformation and stuff like that. In, for a pineal, of course, you go a little bit more superior. The dura incision, dura opening is important that you be able to control the arachnoid. Once you open the arachnoid, is much better, is good exposure. And then closure, usually for chiari malformation, for example, if after I decompress the tonsils, and the floor of the fourth ventricle, and then you inspect the obex, you see the floor of the ventricle, you make sure everything is okay, and you can put a loose, very loose dura graft, which is sewn in place in a watertight fashion. There are some options for the graft. Will include, for example, fascia lata with harvest from the leg, or you can use a bovine or cadaver dura graft, or even possibly a pericranium. Usually, it's difficult to obtain a piece of pericranium which is large enough to cover the entire dura opening for this particular operation. But you know, it's possible. But it's good, particularly if you need to decompress. Usually, put a dura flap at this level. Yeah.
Hey everyone, Ryan Rad here from neurosurgerytraining.org. If you like that video, subscribe and donate to keep our content available for medical students across the world.